we saw in the first video, the increase in the emission of greenhouse gases, and mainly CO2, in turn increases the greenhouse effect, capturing more of the energy coming from the sun and adding it to the climate system. This has been the conclusion of the assessment reports of the IPCC. The IPCC, or Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, regroups thousands of scientists from all over the world. These draw up, every few years, a comprehensive portrait of the state of knowledge of climate science, the assessment reports. The latest, published in 2013, explored the extent of increase of energy kept in the climate system, its origins, and its potential for actual consequences. Here, we'll look at some of these consequences on some of the elements that make up the complex interdependent system of the climate. We'll look first at the evolution of CO2 emitted and how it is distributed in the system. We'll then take a look at the effects this has on the atmosphere, on the oceans, and on ice. Let's first look at CO2 emissions. Humans have been actively releasing more carbon in the air since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution. We are burning more and more fossil fuels every year to keep up with the demand in energy of the ever-increasing population. About half of the CO2 that has been released in the last century has been absorbed by oceans and plants. But the other half is accumulating in the atmosphere, where its concentration has increased by 40% since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution, going from 280 parts per million to roughly 400 parts per million in the last years. One consequence of the increase of CO2 in the oceans is that when CO2 dissolves into water, it turns into carbonic acid, and it makes the ocean a bit more acidic. This can have deep impacts on the ocean food chains, like through the dissolution of corals. The increase of CO2 has significant consequences for the atmosphere. Its global temperature has increased by around 0.9 degrees Celsius compared to the late 19th century, and most of that warming has taken place since the middle of the 20th century. Even if some debate still remains on the validity of the interpretation of the data available, this difference of 0.9 degrees Celsius is a significant change that is already having observable environmental impacts on the planet. And in some areas, like in the North American Arctic, the change has been larger, and that has consequences that we'll come back to later. Then there are the consequences for the oceans. A lot of the excess energy of the climate system is absorbed by the surface of the ocean, since it takes significantly more energy to heat up water than to heat up air. This rise of water temperature has various consequences. First, water expands when it gets warmer, and so the level of the oceans is rising. Oceans are about 20 centimeters higher than they were in 1900, and the rate at which they rise is accelerating. Second, when water gets warmer, there is less gas that can be dissolved in it. This means less oxygen in some areas, and it also means less CO2 that is being released back into the atmosphere, causing further warming and thus more CO2 getting released into the atmosphere. This sort of feedback mechanism is common in the climate system. Which brings us to the third element, which is the consequences for ice cover. The warming of the Arctic Ocean leads to the melting of the ice covering it. More ice melts during the summer, which means that highly reflective sea ice is replaced by more dark, open oceans, which absorbs more energy, melting more ice, and so on, creating a feedback loop. In the last decade, there has been a shift between summers where the minimum extent of the ice cover was between 4 and 5 million square kilometers, to summers where the ice minimum is closer to 3 million square kilometers. Besides the melting of sea ice, there are also a lot of worldwide observations of glaciers retreating, and in particular loss of ice covering Greenland and Antarctica. This has somewhat increased the global level of the oceans, although most of the sea level increase is attributed to water expansion rather than to land ice melting. In the Arctic, large areas of land that used to stay permanently frozen are melting deeper during the summer, which has consequences for the environment by producing coastal erosion, and also has a direct impact for people living in these areas where building and infrastructure is built in consequence of a permanently frozen ground. More importantly, the melting of ice releases huge amounts of trapped methane gas originating from the thawing and decaying of organic matter. This methane is a greenhouse gas that is 20 times more powerful than CO2 and is another part of the feedback loop between a warming world and more warming. But what are all those changes leading to? We'll see what the future impacts of climate change might be in the next episode.